Welcome. Power BI just released small multiples for cards, and in this video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about how to use this feature. So let's dive into it. Firstly, what are small multiples for cards? So say you've created this card here. It's three KPIs and a single card measure, but you want to break it out over any other dimension. Well, small multiples allow you to do that. For example, this way breaks it out by row. Now we can see the small multiples of this card KPI by row. This other way does it by column. We can see it by column. I'm going to show you the intricacies of how to set this up and how to utilize it. If you find this valuable and you want more Power BI content, hit subscribe, hit like, leave a comment. I read every question that you send over. So let's dive into Power BI Desktop. Let's go. All right, so here we are in Power BI Desktop. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do to follow along with this video is go to the description, go to the GitHub, and download this file. This will allow you to follow along. We're going to have two labs. You can follow along and utilize this file to do that. We're going to cut right to the point as well. So firstly, you'll see at the top of this file is a KPI card, fully built out with reference labels, division, the whole deal. What we're going to do is focus on the small multiples for this video. So if you want to see how to build this card, then go to this video here. It's also going to pop up on the screen. It will detail how to build this. So let's get going. How this file is laid out is we have the card detailed summary. We're going to talk about the grid summary. Then we're going to go through a single column explanation, a single row explanation, and show you the intricacies of how to set this up with this new formatting. It's going to be right to the point. So let's go. Firstly, you're going to see some things like single column and single row. It's kind of inverse to what you might envision in your head, but you'll quickly understand how to follow along with it. So when you do a single column, it's going to make multiple rows by keeping everything kind of in one big old column, as you'll see. Secondly, the single row is going to have everything in columns because all the data will be in one row horizontally, somewhat inversely to the headers. So you'd almost think this would be multiple rows and this would be multiple columns, but instead it's a single column, single row. I'm going to show you what that means, or a grid where you can box everything together. So firstly, what we're going to do is build this in a column view. And to do this lab, we're going to take this card we've already created, copy it, move it over to single column lab. So if you're just watching the video, this is where you'll see the differences. I'm going to explain what those are. So you'll see multiple small multiples layout is grayed out, small multiples header is grayed out. We're going to enact both of those and you'll see what they are. That's going to be the focus of this video. One thing to kind of see is you can still change, obviously, the values and the dimensionality of the visuals you put in here. What I mean by that is the layout itself is going to refer to the card, and you can see how this is a single row or a single column. And a single column has many rows, single row has a single row. But it's going to kind of flip. I'm going to show you something interesting here. So for this example, we're going to add the store region. And to do that, in this attribute, it has a bunch of sales data, but all you need to focus on is bringing the store region or anything in your KPIs to the small multiple section. And you'll see at first it's going to look a little wonky, but I'm going to show you all the details for how to set this up. All right, so the first thing you notice is that the small multiples layout and the small multiples header are both now available. And you just need to know how to use these to get this visual to work. So I'm going to show you first an interesting thing I discovered. When you pick the small multiples layout or the layout, they kind of are related behind the scenes. What I mean by that is if we just make this visual fill the whole screen, say I go to the layout arrangement, which we just were looking at, and change this to single column, it's going to change that to single row. If I change this back to single row, it's going to change that to single column. If I change this to grid, it changes that to grid in the bottom as well. So when you first create it, it's kind of set up automatically to make the inverse occur with the layout, with the small multiples layout. So again, if we're looking at this, the layout is a single column. When we come back to our grid summary, the single column will create multiple rows as everything's in one column. So now that we're in this visual, let's look at the different fields and how to use them for the small multiples layout. So you have a KPI, you just separated it out. We want to see everything. So you can see initially you can scroll, but how do you control these things? That's going to be the part of this video. So small multiples layout, going through each of these sections. We've already set it up as single column. Again, if you start changing it, single row, you'll see how that flips it the other way. And we'll do a visual with that too. But you'll notice in this case, it went single row, but the layout itself is still single column. So there's a lot of nuances with that. I'm going to come here. The small multiples shown, right now it's 1, 2, 3. You can see you just scroll to get to the rest of them. Let's go ahead and increase that to 6. Now I've just brought in everything here. So the small multiples shown will allow you to determine how many you want in your visual. Maybe you want just a couple, maybe a few less you want to scroll, but that's what this is going to do. If we turn on and off the borders and grid lines, you'll see what they represent. So first I'll just turn them both off. You'll see the border here. I'll make this a little bit smaller so we can see it. If I come back to this visual, turn off the grid lines and the borders, you'll see that everything is kind of floating out here in space. Well, if we come back to here, turn on the border will be around the whole entire visual of this gray line. Grid lines will come on like this. So in this case, you can format either the border or the grid line the same way. So let's do this one by say knocking it up to, 7. We'll pick a color that's a little less light. And I use something different with this one. I actually use white, and that's a kind of a cool trick I'm going to show you. So one thing that you might want is to control the space between these cards. And a fun way to do that is by actually using this grid and setting the grid itself up as a color of white, because we're going to set the background of these small multiples here too. I'll show you what that means. So if we come to the background now, we'll turn the background on. The background's going to be the space in between the card, not the background of the whole visual, but just of the layout section. So maybe let's make this a lighter kind of color like this. But now what we might want to do is come back to the grid lines, make the grid lines white to kind of create this idea of space, expand them a little bit more. And now you're kind of having this visual that kind of chunks things out, which is pretty cool. So we'll collapse that back down. The background we've set and overflow. So if, say for example, we came back to the small multiple shown and we went back to 3, well maybe we wanted to, you can choose on the right hand side, the continuous scroll. Again, the point of this video is to show you the options for how to set this visual up. Or you can pick paginated. Paginated gives that experience where you kind of click through and I jump to 3, I can jump back up to 3. In this case, we'll keep it to continuous scroll and we'll come back up here and set the small multiples back to 6 to show everything. So we're getting everything that we needed here. One thing that you might start to notice as you create small multiples and is that you'll have to adjust the actual values in the layout itself to have them all fit together. So what that means is previously, if we come back to say this card detail, well, you can see they were larger, there was more space to take up. Again, small multiples is not there, but this spacing is kind of larger. So what you can do is as you're creating these visuals, remember you always can still set the reference label size and the reference label any kind of features and functionality. So if we come back to all under reference labels, well now, maybe if we come down to spacing, padding after, let's kind of just bring these things back over like so. Layout, you know, now we're bringing, now we're kind of collapsing things back together. If I come back over here, again, we'll come down to the spacing and you can see the space between labels is set to 10. Well, let's put that to 0. We want everything to fit in there. And then just like I was doing, we can move this back to the left, keep things more condensed. So you're set up that way. So remember, as you're creating this, you can always go back and adjust the values and the layout of the KPI to have them fit, which we'll do again when we go to single row. So that is all you need to know for the small multiples layout. But now what about the formatting on the left-hand side? How do you kind of adjust that? So that's going to be the small multiples header section. And this will give you some of the functionality similar like that's in the KPI itself, where this layout is the overall layout, but the small multiples header, you can pick which specific one. So say I just wanted to format Atlantic only, then you could pick this and format only Atlantic. In this case, we will format them just as they are. But what I'll do is I'll set the background. We'll put that to black too, just to kind of make it pop. Again, set the background, the colors to whatever you want. The point of this is the functionality. And if we come back to the small multiples header, and now we're at this location, we'll pick the title. We want the color of the font to be white so it shows up. And the two kind of things you can choose are the position, so the options. So the orientation, horizontal, is obviously left to right. Vertical, up and down, takes less space. That's good. Let's use that. And if you want to then adjust this to say put it in the center, make it even bigger if you see fit, that's great. What you can enable as well is text wrap. So you can see when I don't have that selected, I have Atlantic, Far West, these regions, but stuff gets cut off. We'll text wrap that sucker up, and now you'll see, okay, cool. It spaces out, Rocky Mountains, Great Lakes, everything as you'd expect, looks good. And again, look at the other video for how to make these KPIs. But now essentially, we can also adjust the padding because sometimes there's a lot of extra space. So if you want to decrease this, you'll see it's very subtle, but you'll see the words moving within that on the right-hand side, zero. I like to do this just to, you know, if you want to make things nice and fit on your screen, there you go. That's going to be the goal of the padding. And then the background as well, we already set that to black, but say you want to pick a different color, you can do that too. And that's how you're going to customize this. So what you used to have to do is create multiple measures and then set those up as separate KPIs, but the small multiples really helps blow up any KPI you need. So we'll go through this next part even quicker just for some additional guidance on how to make like the single row work, because you'll see this looks a little bit different with no icon. So we'll do the same process. And now that we've created this, I'll just copy it, come to the single row lab, and I'll paste this. So this is going to be now where we're going to go through that process again of the grid versus the row versus, you know, what's that layout option for us. So if we come here, we're going to pick single row, and you'll have to change a couple things because we changed it to single row. So now everything's in one spot, but we have to come back up to the layout, change this to single column. So it's stacked up. And doing this process will be beneficial because it's just going to help you understand how to set these up on your own semantic models or your own reports that you're building, because we're going to flip some things in the cart as well. And understanding these settings is just going to, you know, increase your skill set. So to get back to the point, if we are here now, let's start going top down. So now that we know where things are located, if we come to the small multiples header, we can say the orientation horizontal. Okay, that's flipped up. That's how we like it, left to right. You'll notice what's kind of cool about this choice is that instead of having to stack it, you do have some more real estate left to right, which is nice. But you're going to be lacking on the card real estate. So I'm going to show you how to make up for that. You'll have to make some decisions in your design. So we have the header, but now let's look at these cards. Okay, so firstly, we need the reference label to be below. So when you go to the reference label, the series, you're going to pick options. Now you can see in the right of callout, well, we're going to want it below the callout. This is the callout value. This is the reference label. So we want it below. All right, we're starting to get shaped up a little bit more here. But unfortunately, just for this one, the icons are not going to work out because there's just a space constraint. So you have to make that decision. So to change that, we're going to come to the images. We're going to pick each series, net sales, turn that off. Sold, turn that off. Return, turn that off. Okay, things are starting to fit again. So now also, you might have to rename some things because you can see this is wrapping. So if we don't want that to wrap, what you can do, and these are kind of, it's neat because it's calling out specific little points of each of the functionality for how to create these KPI cards. But what you can do is go to the reference labels and we'll pick specifically returned. then maybe we're just going to select the label called returned absolute. And instead of calling it return number, let's just call it maybe RTN. Okay, and again, pick whatever name you want, but this is where you can customize the labels within the reference label. So it's important to know that. Not everything fits, everything's rocking there, but if you want to adjust the size, maybe that's another key feature you want. So what you can do is in the callout value section, then in the layout of that, there's a callout size, it's a percentage. So it was a 55, if I decrease this, you'll see it kind of moves it up. And you can toggle that as you want. There's a lot of detailed functionality and settings you can play with these. So now you have figured out through this video how to set up single row small multiples, single column small multiples, and you are equipped to use these in your own model in any way that you see fit. So enjoy this. And again, if you found it valuable, like, leave a comment, share it with your friends. I will always respond to any questions that are asked. You take care. Talk to y'all later. Bye.